Here at the Bronfman Center, we always say that you never graduate from a family. And why is that?
It is precisely because your presence in our community sustains us, challenges us, comforts us, and changes us.
Your learning, your insights, your leadership, your experimentation with new ways to gather Jewishly, your creativity, and your kindness.
All of these gifts bless us, the Bronfman Center staff. And all of these gifts bless the students to come in the future.
So now, we at the Bronfman Center bless you. May you truly see your accomplishments recognized, and may you feel pride in all of your work here.
Our sages mused, may your eyes shine with the light of Torah. We've learned together from pages of Talmud and from the streets and architecture of downtown Manhattan.
May your learning enlighten those you encounter throughout your lives.
You're graduating in a way that none of us could ever have anticipated. And in many ways, it isn't fair or fun.
But we know from our own community, especially over the last 4 years, that we are resilient. We persist.
Rabbi Alexandri prayed that God might place us, quote, in a lighted corner and not in a darkened corner.
We hope you experience much light in your lives.
And in times of darkness, we know, as the Jewish community, that even the tiniest spark can illuminate.
May you find the light of our community shining for you in dark times. And may you be a light for all who surround you.
We will miss you, each of you. No matter where you go, you are always a part of what makes this place home.
There's a blessing in the Talmud that reads, may you see your world in your lifetime. There is so much to see in the world in your lifetimes.
May you take what you learned at university and at the Bronfman Center and see it flourish in your unfolding lives.
Class of 2020, y'all have been our students and our teachers, leaders, creators, and innovators.
You've been interns.
And cooks.
And sukkah builders.
And Zoom conference conveners. And late night chatters with Sidibe.
You've danced till your feet ached at the Metropolitan Pavilion.
You've waited eons for the elevator and noshed on leftovers from the first floor fridge.
And you've mourned at vigils for those killed in acts of anti-Semitism and hatred of all kinds. You've comforted one another and challenged us all.
May you be catalysts for change that makes the world feel more connected. May you be stewards of Jewish tradition and learning. May you know peace. May you know pride. May you know resilience. And to that we say,
Amen.
B'chaim.
Amen.